Mark Twain once remarked how easy it is to make people believe a lie and how hard it is to undo that work again. Mark Twain was right. More than a year since Trump left office, the big lie has only gotten bigger. As CNN's Donie O'Sullivan shows us, it's taken on a life of its own.
What you're seeing and what you're reading is not what's happening.
Former President Donald Trump's relentless attacks on the truth has eroded faith in American democracy and its institutions.
You don't trust the election officials.
Nope.
Nope.
You don't trust the FBI.
Nope.
You don't trust the courts.
Nope.
Who do you trust?
Trump and his supporters.
I trust.
And anybody that has in that, that when I listen to them talk, they don't turn my stomach with the disingenuousness.
Do you have trust and faith now in American democracy and American elections?
No. I mean, I think whoever wins, wins. I'm all about that. He will win if he runs again. But the people that know that we were cheated are almost at the point of saying, I don't want to vote because it'll happen again. Because it'll happen again.
What is your reaction to a hearing from an American like that?
Well, 10 years ago, it would have been shock and disbelief. And I would have thought, well, she's an outlier and she's not representative of anything larger than a fringe movement, maybe. But of course, that's not the case anymore.
Barbara Walter is a professor at the University of California in San Diego. She has studied civil conflict for years, from Yugoslavia to Northern Ireland.
Experts who've studied civil wars and know the warning signs, we've been talking about them, but nobody wanted to believe it. And January 6th made it impossible to deny and ignore that there really was this cancer growing in our own country. There was a threat that was mobilizing.
She warns the constant barrage of lies undermining American elections from right-wing media, on social media, and from Trump himself has put the United States on a perilous path.
Citizens do believe what they are hearing, and if they hear it long enough and consistently enough, and if that's all they hear, they absolutely don't think it's a lie. They think it's the truth.
Will you trust the next election?
Probably not.
But that's a terrible thing, right?
Oh yeah, it's a terrible thing.
I don't think you can trust our government anymore. It's sad, but I really don't think you can.
That's what Trump is all about, making the elections in the future fair so we can believe when you vote for somebody, that person's going to get your vote.
You know, they're good people. They're trying to do what they think is right. It's the leadership that's cynical. It's the leadership that knows better, who's feeding them lies consistently.
They always talk about the big lie. They're the big lie.
While just 30% of Americans think there is solid evidence that there was widespread fraud in the 2020 election, 62% of Republicans say so. Looking ahead to the 2022 midterm elections, only 42% of Republicans say they're somewhat or very confident the results will be counted accurately.
They're priming their supporters to believe that democracy isn't worth defending because they don't want democracy anymore.
And Donie O'Sullivan joins me now. Donie, great piece as always. You know, I'm kind of curious, you know, when you talk to these Trump supporters, do they have any ideas for an alternative to democracy? I guess maybe it's dictatorship. The Trump dictatorship?
Yeah, Jim, I mean, you know, we've spoken to, I guess now, hundreds of Trump supporters all across the country over the past year and since the election. And, you know, we have heard from people along the way when there was a coup happening in Myanmar last year, people kind of, Americans, Trump supporters, looking to that, saying, oh, that would be great if we had that happen here and Trump was put back in power. What I did notice being at Trump's most recent rally in Arizona a few weeks ago was, you know, we spent so much of the past year hearing fantastical claims about Venezuelan voting machines and bamboo paper and everything else, and that's how the election was supposedly stolen. Right. The messaging seems to be a little bit more disciplined now, and we're hearing less and less of that from people, and more support, more just straight support for those restrictive voting measures that Republicans are putting in place at the state level. So what we're seeing now is the base has been laid, where there's all these conspiracy theories. People truly believe some of them. Some of them really truly believe the election was stolen. Some of them know it's a talking point and know better. But some people, I think, as you saw in that piece, people literally draped in the American flag. believing this kind of stuff, and that is now they're giving their support to these kind of restrictive measures we're seeing across the country.
Well, thank you for what you do, Donie. I hope deprogramming some people one person at a time, but great work as always, Donie. Thanks so much. We appreciate it.